I don't, you know what, it, I think it just reinforced the fact that if we don't compete and stay structured and play as a team, that we can get embarrassed like we did on Saturday. And again, you know, there's two teams on the ice. You know, UMass, I don't think played their best hockey on Friday night. I think we made mistakes in the second period to give them power play, you know, like 7 or 8 minutes of power play time that they capitalized on. And then the third period, I thought we really controlled the play. And I don't think they were happy with their performance. So they elevated their game, and despite what we tried to tell our guys about what they were going to see the next night, it was too much for us. And I just didn't like how, as the game wore on, we wilted. You know, you talk about bending but don't break. We broke at the end, and that was really disappointing. I think our message was loud and clear post-game, and certainly we regrouped on Monday. Players had a meeting on their own to talk about being accountable and just taking more pride in what they were doing, you know, and I think we were all pretty embarrassed and disappointed about it. And that's it's a whole group. It's not, hey, us pointing fingers at players. It's, hey, as a coaching staff all the way down, like we have to be so much better if we just to give ourselves a chance to win. Like we could play awesome and still come up short. But we didn't give ourselves a chance to win on Saturday. So hopefully you don't like to have that kind of a lesson right now, especially in our situation in the standings, but hopefully it was a wake-up call and can fuel us going into this weekend and beyond.
Just seeing what UMass has done over these past couple of seasons, going from a bottom feeder in the conference to number one team in the country, does that give you guys hope knowing that, you know, you guys could turn it around just as quickly like that?
Yeah, I think so. You know, there's certain reasons for their turnaround. Obviously, they've done a great job in recruiting, and they've completely, you know, flipped their roster in a lot of ways. And Greg's a good coach, you know, and they've created a culture there, you know. And we certainly have, I think, a very positive culture going right now. And I think as we continue to, the building's going to be a big part of it for us in terms of recruiting. But you know, we're so focused on right now that this team is certainly capable of doing better than what we have. And that's our job as coaches right now, is to bring that out. We've played well in non-conference games. We've lost some tight ones in league, but we haven't done a good enough job in Hockey East to get us out of where we're at right now. So, you know, your record is indicative of what you are. And right now we're a last place team that's got to scratch and claw our way out of this situation. And I love our guys. I love our team. I know what's in there. Just hoping that they can bring it out of themselves, and we'll do our best to try to bring it out as well.
You've talked multiple times throughout the course of the season about the mental toughness of this group and how much you've been impressed by it. Is this the ultimate test of that then?
No, for sure.
What this weekend was?
For sure. I mean, I think a lot of good things were said on Monday. By the coaches, by the coaching staff, not just me, by the players to themselves. But that's I don't want to say that's the easy part. That's a very important part of it. But executing it and putting it into action, in game situations, that's going to be the true test. But again, I think it's a very, very good group. I love the way we've practiced and competed this week, and I think a lot of a lot of coaches would be pretty worried coming off Saturday night that, are the guys still believing in each other? Are they still believing in what we're doing? I don't sense for a second that there's not belief that they can be better than what they showed to date. So I'm excited to see them play on Friday night. You know, really excited.
You mentioned the standings, and you're a last place team, and the guys realize that as well. How much of a challenge is it to maintain that game-by-game focus when they know that it's a tall hill to climb to get to where you want to get?
It's a tall, long hill. I think that's the biggest one, right? Like to think about is that there's still an awful lot of Hockey's points at stake. We certainly play a lot of great teams, but there's a lot of great opportunities in front of them, and we just have to knock the door down and get after it. We can't just knock. We gotta knock that door right down, and hopefully our guys have that mentality. That it's, hey, what a great story it will be, at the end of the season that we were the comeback kids. And I hope that's what they believe, and I hope that's the approach they take. That's certainly my approach.
How do you feel about Steph being one of the contenders for
Well, I mean, again, Steph is a special goaltender, special player for us in so many ways. You know, in his mentality, his work ethic, how hard he plays for his teammates, and what he's been able to do statistically on a team that, you know, is under 500, and certainly, like you said, in the bottom right now of Hockey East. You look at his statistics, and they speak volumes for what he's done. You know, I know the Hobie Baker doesn't often come from a team that is struggling or has struggled, but he's been our MVP. He certainly deserves to have these accolades. I know right now that doesn't mean anything to him. You know that he's so focused on trying to help this team turn things around that I don't even know if he knows that yet. So that says a lot about him.
Is it nice knowing that? Yeah, the Hockey East record isn't pretty, but you guys are only 5 points out of the playoff spot. Like, it's very,
right.
It's a very, you know, mountable comeback you guys get if you just string a couple wins together.
Right.
Is it nice just, is that what you're focusing on? Not like looking at it as a whole, but just like, we're only this far back and we can easily overcome it.
Yeah, it's I think I said this to you guys earlier, like the telescope is this long at the beginning of the year. We start looking at it in that way that we just can't. We can't afford to look at the end right now. We have to chip away and try to get points every weekend. And like you said, you string together, you know, 3-4 games, like you're right back in the thick of things. You know, it's a league where, you know, a couple teams have kind of separated, and then after that it's everybody's beating everybody on any given night. So that should be encouraging to our guys, you know, and again, there's a lot of hockey to be played, and we're excited about it.
What do you want the guys to focus on the most heading into this
weekend? Compete level, playing together as a team in all areas, you know, and just everybody's got to up it. Everybody's got to do their job better, you know, not worry about what somebody else's job is or, you know, trying to do too much. Just do your job, you know, as well as you possibly can. As a coach, it's all we can ask. Okay, thanks, everyone.
So Coach said that, you know, along with the message from the staff, that you guys had your own conversation at the beginning of the week. What was the message amongst the players?
It was just, coming out of Saturday, it was just that we needed to compete. We didn't give us a chance to win Saturday night. But Friday night, we felt that we gave ourselves a pretty good chance to win. 5-on-5, we took some undisciplined penalties that put the best power play in the country and gave them some goals. So we know that we can beat the best team in Hockey East, so we can compete with the majority of the teams that we're going to play. But we need to compete and show up every night and play as a team.
How do you guys approach these weekends now, especially after what may have been the toughest weekend of the year? How do you approach it knowing that you really are only 5 points out of the playoff spot right now? It's not an insurmountable, you know, margin.
Yeah, we're just taking it game by game. I mean, you can look at the standings and see us at the bottom, but we're really not that many points behind. But it doesn't help to look too far down the road and count how many games we have left. So we're just taking it like Friday night. We're just focusing on Friday and just trying to get those 2 points.
Lowell's traditionally been a difficult place for any Vermont team to play. What are you expecting from Lowell, and how do you go about counteracting?
Well, from my past 2 years, they're just a hardworking team. Nobody really stands out for them. They just all do their jobs, and I think they're kind of like us in that sense. We're not going to win with skill. We're going to win with all our guys playing together, and I think we just have to counter that by competing harder than them and winning those battles.
Coach mentioned accountability, both by the players, the coaches, everybody. How do you go about that as a captain to take that step, to hold people accountable and not go too far?
I mean, it's a balance because there's frustration levels, but there's also, you want to stay positive and keep the morale up and let guys know that we can win, but also there's no excuses for Saturday. Like, we just didn't show up to play, and we needed to let guys know that we can't, we're not going to win games if we play like that. I think just those one-on-one battles in the corners and helping other teammates out in those battles. We want to shut things down because we were chasing at UMass. We were just chasing the puck in our D zone and getting tired. So we're trying to shut things down quick and then get the puck out of our zone, not play in our D zone. Thank you.
So in your mind, what was the message on Monday, not just from the coaches, but from the leaders to the team, you know, coming out of this weekend?
Yeah, I think it's just a mentality and, like, how we can't just flip a switch on Fridays and Saturdays to turn our compete level up, and especially against a team like that, number one team in the nation. That's just not going to get it done. That's not how it works. So really just focus on Monday and getting practice this week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Competing with ourselves and pushing each other and really just forcing each other to play our best every single day so that by the time the weekend comes around, we're ready to go and there should be no worries about whether or not we're competing or not.
Coach has talked throughout the course of the season about the mental toughness that he has seen in this group. And you know, as a leader, is this the biggest test of that coming off with such a frustrating thing and knowing the task that's still ahead of you?
Yeah, I think that it's definitely frustrating. You can point to different parts in the season that will really spotlight that and really prove that what type of team we are. And definitely this weekend coming up is one of those times where we're really going to show what we're made of. And I have all the confidence in the world that we're going to respond. And we have a really good group of guys in the locker room. And as you said, our mental toughness this year has been amazing. And I think that we're going to bounce back, and the mood's been great. So there's been really no issues on that.
A number of very close losses that you played well in.
Yeah.
Has that just taken a toll on the team, you think, at times where maybe it kind of built up to that again after another good effort Friday night and yet no reward?
A little bit. I mean, it's just we know we're right there, and we just need to tweak a couple things. Be able to compete for the whole 60 minutes. We can't just show up in the first and third period like we did on Friday night and unfortunately pretty much none of the periods on Saturday to get it done. We're a team that we got to play a full 60 minutes, get it done, especially with Steph in that. He really keeps us in a ton of games and is the reason why a lot of those one-goal losses are probably one goal and not more. So we got to really turn things around in that aspect and flip the switch and us be on the other end of those close games. Yeah, I think this year, I don't know how many times that's happened, but really Saturday, that was the focus, and that was one of the reasons why there was some frustration after this weekend, is as my coach mentioned and Matt mentioned, that the compete level wasn't there, and that's really what let us down and then let Steph down, and just not going out there and giving it all, and we kind of just hung them out to dry in a sense.
Yeah. Remembering what coach is telling you throughout the game.
Well, yeah, it's playoff hockey now. So we do have a ton of games left in Hockey East. But, I mean, if you look at the standings, we do need points. And, you know, we've won four or five games in a row already this year. So there's no question that we can do that again. So we just focus one game at a time and focus on our game plan. And I would say, you know, the desperateness, you know, us playing desperate – comes down to that compete level that I've mentioned a couple times, is if we're competing and we're playing hard just like we're trying to do in practice and create that consistency and work ethic, then I think that we don't need to play desperate because we'll be just playing our game and we'll be getting some points in the standings.
How do you keep
probably not to think about it in that way. The mindset's been positive all week, and forget, we got to move on. We got to focus on UMass Lowell now and forget about what happened last weekend. That's the best way to move on and focus on what we need to do, what we need to make adjustments on, execute those, compete, and get 4 points this weekend.
What's the main thing you guys
got to
adjust and
focus on? I'd say shutting things down in our D zone and getting out in transition. Our D zone is really focused on getting things shut down as quickly as we can. And if that doesn't happen, we kind of run around. And if we shut things down, we got to be able to transition up the ice and get some offense and get more shots for sure. I think we only had like 10 shots on Saturday. That's unacceptable. So we really need to bump those numbers up to give ourselves a chance to even score and win.
Do